Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. I welcome you to this wonderful episode 007 today. Godly Diet Counseling Session with Olumide. And I hope you have been blessed through our previous episode. And I pray the Lord will continue to bless every one of us in the name of Jesus. Today, we want to have another drama to present to you. And it's going to be a wonderful one. It's a glorious one because God is in it. We will use every means to preach the word of God through word ministration, through drama, through song, and through all means. And only the name of God will be glorified. And today we have a drama to present. And as you watch, I think the Lord is going to be ministered to every one of us in the name of Jesus. Please, you can share this video as join us, and I pray the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. So, watch out for this drama. God bless you.
Hello. What is this? I thought they were ordinary papers when I picked them up 2 days ago. Eh? Ordinary paper. That's what I thought. Ah. Eh? Phew. Is this possible? This one is for 10 months ago. This one 8 months ago. Ah. This one is even last week. Hey, okay. Oh God. Who is this? Hello? Hello? Ah, good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Yes, sir. Ah, you mean you've been trying to reach pastor? Oh, yeah, I think he's on another line. Yes. How's the family, sir? I'm good to hear from you. Okay. You want me to pass a message across to him? Okay, it's very urgent. No, don't worry, go ahead and tell me. No problem, I will tell him. What did you just say? Eh? My husband. No, it's okay, sir. No problem, sir. Okay. I will let him. I will inform him. No problem. I'm sorry, are you sure? And since when is this one? No, you know, we women, we sometimes forget this, eh? Okay. Thank you, sir. Okay, I will deliver the message to you. All right, sir. Okay, sir. Bye bye, sir. Hey, Jesus. Am I dreaming? This is a confirmation now. Am I dreaming? Hey! What's going on here?
Okay, Mr. Collins. Like I was saying, please take time to help your wife. Hey? Have you forgotten what the Bible says? That it will help our wives. We should dwell with them in knowledge so that our prayers will not be hindered. Hey? And I've been warning you, encouraging you, Mr. Collins. Eh? And you keep on complaining that your wife is not happy. Please help your wife. With her so sure. Eh? This is what I've been preaching every Sunday, every Monday, every time. Eh? And I pray the Lord will help you in the name of Jesus. Be a good husband. God bless you. Bye. Yeah, I'm going to the church for counseling. Two families are waiting for me. So, yeah, look at the time now. It's almost after one, and I prayed in the morning, but I need to eat the lunch now. But maybe just try to prepare the lunch when I come back in the evening.
Don't you even pity me at all, eh? This This is after one. Yes. You don't even know whether I'm eating this morning myself.
You know, I've been preparing messages, I've been studying the Bible. I mean, it's your duty to cook for me, to prepare everything for me.
Man of God,
yes.
Since 6 a.m. I've been off. I prepare the children for school.
Yes.
I arrange for your breakfast.
Yes.
You've eaten breakfast, you've done everything. I'm still cleaning the house, arranging the whole place. Now you are going for counseling.
God is your strength.
And you said, I should.
God is your strength.
God is my strength.
Yes.
But what stop you from helping me to do one or two things? Now, I heard you counseling people, they should help their wife, oh, man of God. Oh.
I'm the head of this family now, you know. I mean, you have this friend. I mean, do you want me to be, do everything in the kitchen with you?
I'm not saying you should do everything in the kitchen with me. You understand me? But a little help here and there. I hear you preach it, but you yourself, you don't do this.
Who told you that? Please.
Who told me that? Am I not your wife? So, am I not living the same house with you?
I'm going, sir. So I'm going for counseling.
Man of God, come back. We will do our own counseling first before you go for their counseling.
What counseling are you talking about now?
Anyway, man of God.
Yes.
Is there something I need to know that you have not told me?
Like what?
Anything. Anything as husband and wife that you feel your wife should know and you have not told me.
Yes. You know you are transparent now. Everything is okay. I love you and everything is okay in this home. So what? I'm not hiding anything from you now.
Man of God,
yes.
My darling husband,
yes.
Are you sure you are not hiding anything?
I'm not hiding anything now.
Okay, man of God. You know, I've been telling you that we should build a house back at home. And you yourself, you told me for about 2-3 years now. We have been talking about it. So when are we going to start the building?
Yeah, I've told you that you should wait for the appointed time. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't have enough money in the account.
Of course, so I know we operate joint accounts, man. I think I know what you
mean. Yes. So
unless maybe there's something I do not know. I should
what
wait for,
again?
I should wait for God's time.
Yes, now. God will build the house for us.
Okay.
I've forgotten the midwives in the Bible. They took care of the Israelites. And God built the house for them.
That is,
you are taking care of these people, God will build our house.
That is what I used to believe. Yes. Man of God.
Yeah, you need to continue to believe that also.
But I don't think I believe the same thing anymore.
Why?
I need to ask you, man of God, sir. Man of God, my husband. Who is Mr. Philip to us in this family?
Mr. Philip?
Yes.
Mr. Philip is one of my close friends now.
Of course I know. Anything apart from that, what is his job? What is he doing?
He's a building contractor.
Building contractor?
Yes, now. I think you know everything about him now.
I need to ask you, man of God, building contractor, Mr. Philip.
Eh?
Okay. So what business are you doing with Mr. Philip these days?
Business?
Yes. Or what are you building together?
No, nothing. We are building spiritual building. You know, we have orphanage in back home. And then it's helping me we are building the spiritual people now.
But Mr. Philip is a house builder, contractor.
Yes, so you are building spiritual people.
He is not building spiritual people with you. You understand me? And I want you to come out openly and tell me.
What do you want to know now?
Mr. Philip, call me this morning. What project have you been doing together that you don't know?
Which project are you talking about?
I need to ask you that.
Which kind of project now?
What project have you been doing together?
Nothing now. I told you I've been doing spiritual project. What do you want me to say again?
And why have you been sending too money to Mr. Philip for the past 10-8 months now?
Money?
Yes.
I'm not sending any money to him. I didn't send any money to him.
Eh?
Huh? Yes.
You did know what?
I didn't send any money to him.
Repeat it, Pastor Peter. Repeat it.
I didn't send any money to him. What
Pastor Peter, repeat it.
I'm going to Peter. Wait.
You are not going anywhere. So, is this not the transaction that you have been sending? Is this not the paper that you have been using to send money? Big money. 1,000 euros, 2,000 euros. And we maintain the same account. Man of God.
Where do you see this account?
Where won't I see? Am I not the one clean?
Was I searching?
Maybe the Bible says that every secret will be made open.
Yes, now.
I was busy doing my normal
job. Yeah, so?
Since you will not even help me doing anything, cleaning the house, and then I saw a pipe fell down from your wardrobe, I pick up the pipe to gather it together.
You are trespassing.
What do you mean I'm trespassing? Are we not supposed to be able to see, man of God? I have many questions for you today. Eh?
Which kind
and
of
you
question?
Must answer me all the questions.
What kind
you
of
have question? Been sending money to Mr. Philip. And Mr. Philip called me this morning and he was trying to reach you on your phone.
Oh
he could
God.
Not
what
get
kind
you.
Of this, what kind
and
of
he's telling you that the money you sent for the roofing of the house is not enough. Man of God. So you are building house, you did not tell me. Eh? Is this the transparency you have been preaching?
Wait.
Hey. Man of God, you are double standard.
This is the way it's coming.
Okay. I keep.
Good afternoon, Sister Deborah. God bless you. How's your husband? Problem again with your husband? What did you do? You bought a car without informing him. Sister Deborah, you need to be transparent with your husband now.
Yeah.
Sister, are you listening to me? You need to be transparent. And your husband has every right to be hungry. Why would you buy a car without informing him? That's not good. That is not godly. Please, just go and beg him. Beg him. You want me to call him? Okay. When I get to the church this evening, I'll call him. God bless you. Be a good wife. Take care of your family. And God will bless you. I'm praying for you. My wife and I are praying for you. God will bless your home. Peace will reign in your home. Transparency in your home. In the name of Jesus. God bless you. Bye.
Pastor, double standard. Before you begin to pray, transparency in somebody's home, you must be transparent in your own home first.
Transparent? What do you mean?
Man up, let me
know. I need to preserve my reputation, please.
Which
mind
reputation
your
are you
preserving? Mind your tongue.
Why you are lying? You are living in lies. You are telling lies. No, you are not going anywhere. Stay back here. Where did you get all this money? After all, we used joint account. Man of God, eh?
You
are
to inform you everything happened, my account.
Is that not the message you have been preaching? Is that not the same thing you tell somebody?
And is it my responsibility to preach the word of God?
And it is also your responsibility to live according to the word of God.
I'm not living
according to the word of God. How can you be sending money home to build a house? I don't know anything about.
I sent money? That period. What
and
you
are building a house.
I don't know.
Man of God, where did you get the money from?
You are using joint account.
Why won't you explain everything?
I'm the head of this family. What do you
mean? It's the scripture that you have been teaching us, not saying be naked and not ashamed.
Yes.
Are you transparent to me? And you are preaching it. See, you are living in lies. You are living in your
Don't twist the word of God.
Me.
Yeah? Don't forget what the Bible says. Husband is the head of the family. So don't stand on that point, please.
The Bible also says in the book of Genesis that the two were naked, they were not ashamed.
Yes.
Which means they were transparent, there was openness between them.
Did that cause any shame in this one? No.
Are we talking about shame now? Is this one not going to be shame?
They are naked and they were not ashamed.
Will you be building a house and you will not inform me? Where did you get the money from? After all, we operate a joint account.
Please.
We are operating a joint account. Eh?
I know.
Pastor. Look at your mind. Yeah? Look at the way you are living. You are living in lies. This is deceit. Eh?
Am I a liar?
Yes, you are a liar. You just denied
all liars.
Yes.
So, don't
you are lying.
Your tongue.
Every time
and
I ask
Pastor,
you, we want to build
Peter,
a house. Pastor Sunday Peter, listen to me. Every time I ask you, we want to build a house. We want to do this one. You will say, God's appointed time.
Yes.
My wife, oh, do you know that our account, we don't have much money there. But man of God, you have not explained to me how you are getting money. And you went in secret. You bought the land. You built the house up until the roof level. If not because your phone was engaged this morning, and because I saw this paper some days ago now, how would they have known that? And yet you will stand on the altar. You'll be teaching. You don't know how long you have been teaching about transparency. But you are teaching us what and what in the church to be transparent to each other.
That is my duty. I'm a pastor. Please, for God's
sake. It is not your duty.
I need to preach the gospel.
You are not supposed to be a teacher of the word only. You must be a doer of the word. That is what the scripture told
me. Am I not doing the word?
You are not doing the word.
Who bought this cloth for you?
You are not doing the word. Okay, you bought clothes for me. Thank you.
So,
you bought clothes. Glory be to God for that.
Yes.
But you are building a house. You are doing every other thing. I do not know about it. And you are lying about it. I was asking you, do you do any project you send me? Are you sending money you don't know? You understand me?
Now,
see, drive in secrecy.
Now, you have known the truth. So, let it lie like that.
It cannot lie like that. You just go to Sister Deborah now. that she should go and apologize to her husband.
Yes, ma'am.
And will you not apologize to me?
Mm-hmm. Apologize to me.
Okay. I think I need to call our spiritual parents.
They are waiting for her.
I need to call our spiritual parents.
Please.
My husband needs attention. Needs correction.
Don't inform our spiritual parents.
But you always tell members that when their husband is misbehaving at all, they should come and report to you.
Please.
Yeah, who do I now report you to?
No.
Hey, Jesus.
Believe their prayers only. Don't tell them anything about our affair, about our home. Oh, please.
Pastor Peter.
We need to protect
Pastor
our reputation.
Peter.
Please.
The husband of Pastor Mrs. Deborah.
Yes.
You are protecting your reputation.
Yes.
But you are living in lies and in ungodliness. No. Sinner, no liar, we enter into the kingdom of God.
Oh,
you said you have broken my trust in you today. Where you've been building a house for 10 months, you did not tell me. I come up, I find that if not because the Lord wants to reveal it, you see, Bible says that there are some people, they are seeing God before them before judgment. It's better I expose you to our spiritual
you
right
to
now.
Discussing the scripture.
I need to tell you, man of God, because you are not living according to what you have.
Mind your tongue.
I need to, after all, I'm also your sheep. You are teaching me to what?
Yeah, that's what I'm telling you.
Back.
You, as a sheep, you need to keep your mouth shut.
As a sheep, I need to keep my mouth shut.
Yes.
So I should only listen to your word. I should not follow your way of life.
Yes.
Me, I will not even follow you. Me,
follow
I will
my
go
word. That's what I want to do.
Me, I will follow the word of God. Because this way you are living, you are not living in accordance to the word of God. Instead of you to own up, to apologize, to go before God and say you are sorry. Eh? You see now, eh? To say you are sorry, you are still defending the case. You are still saying you are right. Eh? You lied to me.
Did you get that money from?
Thousands
Grace,
of euros.
Sister Grace, Peter.
Eh? Have you added grace to my name again?
Yes, I mean, did not just second them. Did you read it in the Bible? Yeah, Abraham apologized to his wife.
Hey.
Or Isaac apologized to his wife.
Jesus.
Or Peter apologized to his wife.
But have you not?
Is it not
in the Bible?
In the
scripture. In the book of Ephesians, that the Lord that we are encouraged that husband should love their wife,
yes.
Should support, should help them. Yes. You've not read that one in the scripture.
I read it.
Eh? So that one is not applicable to you. You are holding on to Father Abraham and Father Isaac.
Each scripture is applicable to each situation. So don't judge.
There was nothing that Father Abraham did that Mother Sarah did not do.
So I don't want to hear anything again. I'm good. I
have
cancer in session with
people. Have mercy upon you.
Please,
you
don't inform
me. I will inform them. I will inform them.
If you inform them,
I will inform them, Pastor Samson the Peters. I will inform them. Eh? Can you just imagine double standard? Double standard is preaching something. He's doing contrary to what he's preaching. Eh? Follow my words, so don't follow my action. Eh? How can we be operating a joint account? We are together, and yet we are so distant to each other. And you are calling and you are encouraging other people who want to go for counseling. They should be transferred to their husband. Father, save my husband. Save this man who is preaching the word and is not living according to the word. Eh? Can you just imagine? Who knows that when the problem comes now, we'll bring it up. Where is he getting all this money? Eh? I'm beginning to wonder what has come over this, my husband. Eh? What has come over him? You are preaching one word, you are living according to, you are living contrary to what you are preaching. Double standard. Eh? Where do I know now? We operate a joint account, yet money is not moving out of it. If not because that man come in, I would have known. He said, husband, take care of your wife, give them good, whatever, support them in the house. Come on, for my husband to finish eating and take plates back to kitchen. He cannot do it. Only me will slave and will do everything. Yet, God, just have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon this man. I need to talk to our parents, and I must do it now. Now is the time.
Praise the Lord. I believe you have been blessed through this short drama. And I pray all the things you have learned will sink into your heart in the name of Jesus. Before I continue, let's look at the word of God briefly. In James chapter 1 from verse 22. James chapter 1 from verse 22. The book of James, chapter 1 from verse 22, I read. The Bible says, be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own self. Verse 23, for if any man be a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like unto a man beholding his natural face in a glass. For he beholdeth himself and goeth his way, and straightway forgetteth what manner of man he was. But whoso looketh into the perfect law of liberty and continued therein, he being not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this man shall be blessed in his deed. Praise the Lord. By the grace of God, we have, from this drama, we can see the pastor preaching the word. And the word of God here is telling us that we should be doers of the word. Be a doer of the word, and not only preacher of the word or hearer of the word. And what do we see today? People telling us, this is what you should do. This is the way you should go. This is the way you should live your life. And they themselves, they are not living according to the word of God. The pastor in the drama, Pastor Sunday Peter, was counseling other people, encouraging other families to be good, to be better in their relationship. But his own family is nothing to write home about. And what is this drama telling us today? That you must read the word of God, study the word of God, obey the word of God. Because the Bible says in that verse 25 that blessed is the man. If you are doing the work of the Lord, doing the word of the Lord, being a doer of the word, then you'll be blessed. Not only preacher of the word or hearer of the word. And this man in his own family, he was not living according to the word of God. He was only concerned about leading people to heaven, preaching the word. So, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, let's take time to follow and obey the word of God. Come what may, stand on the word. It is better for you to focus on your own life. Because the Bible says, take heed unto yourself and then to them that hear thee. Take heed unto yourself. You must take heed to yourself. Be careful. Look at your own life. Are you obeying the word of God? Obey the word of God. Live according to the word of God before telling other people to live according to the word of God. And I pray the Lord will give us the grace to be doer of the word in the name of Jesus. Now look at that man. He was hiding things from his wife. As husband and wife, the Bible says, they were naked and they were not ashamed. So you must be open to one another. Whatsoever you are doing, as a man, as a woman, as a husband, as a wife, as a child, as a parent, you must be open. Because sin thrives in secrecy. So you must be open. And I pray the Lord will give us the grace in the name of Jesus. Perhaps you might have been hiding things from your spouse. It is time for you to restitute your way. Go and tell him, I'm sorry, this is what I've been doing. And then restitute your way. And then also, you must be open to each other. You must be ready to say, I'm sorry. Don't leave the whole household shut to your spouse, to your wife. Husband, let's help our wives. Let's help them. It doesn't reduce us. It doesn't diminish our status. So help your wife. Help in taking care of the children. Help your spouse in everything, because two are better than one. And I pray the Lord will help us. So this is summary of the drama today. And in any other way the Lord might have ministered to you, I pray the Lord will give us the grace to be doers of the word in the name of Jesus. Thank you, and God bless you. Have a nice week. God bless you. Bye.